Okay, so we're back with our Thunderbird from the TV show Vegas. Here's where we are. The interior is now permanently attached. It's in there for good now. We glued it in there. But putting that in caused us some grief also, because when we went to put it in, it wouldn't stay properly. Even though you put it on the posts here and you clipped it here in the front, it still wanted to pop out. What I ended up doing is I used some clamps. I got a clamp here. And then I have these microfiber rags. So what I did is put the microfiber rag over top and clamp this down to hold that interior in place like that. Again, with the microfiber between the body and the clamp. Clamped that sucker down real good and glued the hell out of it. Let it sit overnight, and you can see it's actually starting to crack here. Some of the glue is starting to crack, so there must be still some pressure on it. But anyway, the problem is when I took it apart, it imprinted the pattern of the microfiber in the paint. So now we have to go through and start polishing and everything again to try to remove that. One step forward, two steps back. So, but we've got the interior in place. Next thing I was looking at is the windshield in this kit. This thing is thick, it's clunky, it's kind of, if you were to do it, be in scale with this is like driving around with a bulletproof glass from a bank teller window. I mean, it's that thick. But I was thinking of vacuum forming and pulling out the vacuum form machine and vacuum forming a nice thinner one. But then I realized there's this huge gap here between the dash and the body. I mean, it's big, it's a honking gap. But when you put the window in, it fits in here. It fits in here. There we go. Well, it fits in there the way it's supposed to. It fits nice and snug, actually. And then, when you take the frame, put it over top, it actually fits up pretty nice. And, well, it's kind of the way it's supposed to be, I guess. But it's still thick. The fit wouldn't be so nice, I don't think, if I was to thin it down with a vacuum form piece. So it's going to have to work out. Have to work that out. Make that work. What else do we have? Oh, the wheels. The wheels. Wheels are over here under pressure. Here are our wheels. Fix it on these. Okay. Alright, here's our wheels. Now the wheels, the back piece here, the back hub here, has a front, and it's a steel wheel, which is pretty nice. If you don't want to use the hubcaps, you got the steel wheel. The problem being is it was chrome, so painting it, the back of it, wouldn't be very good. Okay, so I had to dechrome that. Then I was fiddling around putting hubcaps on, and if you look at the real car, the rims were painted the color of the body. So when you put the hubcap on, between the white wall and the cap, you would see the color of the car. So what I decided to do was just a feature that I really liked. So what I decided to do is I carefully painted the rim of the hubcap red, which was difficult because it was chrome and paint just kept coming off. But once I finally got a good coat on it all, on all four of them, I took them outside, sprayed them with clear coat, and that sealed it in, and I think they're in a good spot now. Then we went to put the white walls on the tires. These are stickers. They didn't stick. Hardly, didn't stick well at all. What I ended up doing for that is trying to figure a way to get them to stick to the car, because painting it just wasn't an option. It just wouldn't work well for me. I know it. So had to get the stickers to stick. What I used was rubber cement from Elmer's. I use this a lot with prop work, stuff like that, foam, glue foam together, stuff like that. It works really well. What I did is I painted the back of the sticker and the wheel itself, put it in place, and then I put it under pressure, as you can see here. And move you over here. Okay. Okay. I put a piece of foam down so it's got some give, because the tires aren't flat. It's not 100% flat surface. There's contours in there. So I put it on the foam, and then I took this big tub of molding clay, put that on top of it. So now it pushes the tires into the foam, which should give it 100% surface mating, and then hold that down into place until it's dry. Actually, it's already been there for a couple days, and it's still trying to come off, but I'm just gonna have to wait it out. Hopefully they'll stick. If not, we'll have to take them off and try it again. But that's where we are at the wheels. Actually, I think that's where we are at the whole kit right now. I think that brings us up to speed. So I gotta get back to work trying to remove the pattern from the microfiber head of the paint, and then we're gonna go from there. So stay tuned. All right, so moving on with our Vegas Thunderbird. We had, of course, more and more issues while you were gone. what we went to do is we went to put the rear tires on, and what I found out was that the tires, when the tires were in place, backtrack a second. If you remember, we only had one axle, metal axle. I had to fabricate something out of some styrene. I found some styrene I had in my stock. I forget what size this is off the top of my head, but it is evergreen styrene. It's the same size as the axle. So I used that. Actually, I had to drill out the hubs of the wheels a little bit to get it to fit, but yeah, it's close enough. So when I put that in place, the wheels were sticking out too far. Even with the wheel hubs here directly against the frame, the wheels stuck out, where if I went to put these wheel covers, the spats, whatever they call them, in place, they were hitting the wheel and sticking out. So we had to take off. Actually, I forgot to take the tape off of the hubs. I'll have to go back and do that. But I've lost my train of thought. So we had to mark, and we took off about a couple millimeters, maybe a 16th of an inch off of each hub to get it to fit, and then glued them right directly to the frame of the car, and then we were able to work with the wheel covers. Now, the funny thing about those is you would think that these would fit. It was silly me. I never even tried to put them in the model at any time to pre-fit them, make sure they did fit. I just assumed they did. Silly me, they didn't. So they were already painted and glossed and everything like that, waiting for installation. So of course I had to work on modifying to get them to fit. And also there is no, the surface that they wanted to fit to was directly to the body. There was nothing, no lips or anything catches for it behind it. So using some really thin styrene scraps that I have laying around, I always keep this stuff around, keep it all. I made some tabs, again, you can see them in here, the white. Put them, I'll say here on this, here I put some across the corner here, and down at the bottom. Glued them into place, let them dry up real good. And then I fit this, the wheel cover in place over top of it, saw where it was, I trimmed the bottoms, and then I was able to actually glue the cover to that plastic. And it stayed in place, so that worked out well. But like these back wheels don't move anymore, which is okay. I do have to go in and touch up the white here and here, and of course take off the tape from the axles. I'm all over with this kit. I'm just no flow whatsoever. Part of it's the kit, majority of it's me. But that's where we are with that. It took a while to get those in place, but they are finally in place, and it's starting to look like a Thunderbird. I got the front grille in place. I got the covers for the headlights also. These caps are in place. I just have to insert the lens covers first. I painted silver behind it, so when I put the clear lenses on, it'll look more like a light than having the red shining through it. I put an antenna on here. You can see here. Just decide. I've always wanted to do that. For some reason, people leave them off their cars all the time, and it's like, I don't know, it just kind of bothers me, so I decided to put one on here. So I drilled through the body using my my micro bits, and then I used a pin, a push pin. Again, I saved those also, as you can see here, from a shirt that I purchased. Push that through, and it is like the perfect height for me. I think it looks good. Then I tried to file down as best I could, or cut the tip of this, and it just wasn't working. What I found is when I could get it to cut on a different needle, that it would deform the top, and I just couldn't get it to file down correctly. So I just left it pointed as it is, and problem is now every time I go to grab the car, I'm poking myself with this. So that sucks, but on the other side of it, it acts as a deterrent for people going to touch the car, because if it's sticking me every time I go for it, it's going to stick other people too. So I'll keep their hands off of it. The next thing, we put in the tail lights. They're in place. We also got the back tire deck built up. I have to do some touch-up on the Thunderbird piece. I told you about that earlier, how soft it was. It doesn't work. I'm going to have to get in there with a micro brush and some red paint and try to fix that, because it just looks awful. Awful, awful, awful. Okay. And then, still working on the body. I'm still having issues with the paint. My fingerprints, you can notice I'm wearing gloves now. Before that, I was just using it with my hands, and see my fingerprints everywhere. It was dulling down the paint. It was smudging it. It's just horrible. So I decided I start wearing gloves. But what I did for the paint so far, I'm probably going to go over it again, because you can see here there's some, fading of the chrome I put on there. But what I did basically is I polished it up with the scratch remover to get rid of. Remember, I had the microfiber print in here. I had my fingerprints all stuck. It wasn't coming out. Even when I used this by hand with my microfiber cloth, it wasn't coming out. It was staying in there. It was just embedded in the paint. So what I did is I dug out this. This is just a cheap one. It flings fibers everywhere, but still. I got this buffing pad. So then I used that at the lowest speed possible on my Dremel, and put the polish on, and then it did a better job. I'm going to have to go over it again one more time, I think, to finalize it. But I think that's going to be as good as I can get it. It's never going to be a show car. So it is what it is. So that is that. Next, we got our windshield. We talked about that, how clunky and thick it was. I got it in place by using canopy glue and clamps. As you can see here, I used my canopy glue, and I stuck the glue on the corners first, then I had to stick them here, and clamped it all down, and then I made a mess of the windshield itself. So using this stuff also, I was able, and the micro and my Dremel buffer, I was able to clean it up really good. But as you can see, when I did that, the chrome went away on the framework, and then the glue detached over here. The canopy glue isn't a really good sticking glue, that's for sure. But anyway, I got it to stick again. I got this in a holding pattern to hold this back in place. I'm gonna have to go over all the chrome pieces again with the chrome pen. As you can see, it's getting dirty again. I'm gonna have to go back and microfilm, polish it up. But I want to make sure I get the chrome done first. So that's where that is. It's just so clunky and thick. It's just horrible. But when it's in place, it really does make the car look better. So we're going to have to get back to that. It, like I said, I'm all over on this. The model is just driving me nuts. And I have no flow. I'm just haphazardly doing stuff. And it's just kicking me in the ass. But yeah, that's where we are. Again, watching my videos is more so not how to build a model. It's how not to build a model. And this one is definitely one of those things. Do not build it like this. Hell, I wouldn't even suggest getting this kit and building it. Unless you want it just for the nostalgia of the box art. Being maybe a Robert Urich fan, you'd have the box art sitting on your shelf. But this kit's just a horrible kit. So, but I'm sure there are a ton of builders out there that can make it look much better. When all that's done, we're going to move on to the final stages. I still got to figure out how to scratch build a phone for this, because he had the phone in the car, if you remember. I still haven't figured out how to do that yet. But one of the things I did figure out is he also had an antenna on the car. On the back of the deck of the car, he had a phone antenna. And I got these. These are antennas for armor builders, okay? I got this stuff in a auction that I got years ago, which I sold off, but I still kept certain parts. And this is one of the things I kept, was the antennas. So this kit's got five antennas. You can see them there. They got the nice coils at the bottom and everything. So I'm going to take one of these, cut it down, and we're going to make a mounting bracket here. And we're going to mount that on the car. And then that should tidy up everything and make a finish off our Dantana Thunderbird. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.